Hello listeners, myself Professor Orpita Dash and I am going to teach you wireless communication and network. In my previous lecture, we are talking about what is wireless communication. Basically, introduction about the wireless communication. What are the differences between wired and wireless communication? What are the different types of wireless communication? Microwave communication, satellite communication, mobile communication, Wi-Fi technology, infrared technology, Bluetooth technology, and the most important is what are the advantages and disadvantages of wireless communication. That was the first presentation. That was in my first presentation. Now in this presentation, we are going to introduce about the evolution of wireless communication. That is the history of wireless communication. So let's start. In ancient time, people used smoke signals, torch signaling, flashing mirrors for communicating purpose. Sometimes people use pigeons to transmit information from one point to another. But that was for ancient time. What about the recent era? First, telegraph network was invented by Samuel Morse in 1838. In 1895, Marconi demonstrated the first radio transmission. So we can say Marconi is the father of radio transmission. The first wireless technology was started through Marconi. Marconi first demonstrated the radio transmission. We can see in 1906, first radio broadcast was started. In 1911, the first mobile transmitter came into the picture. In 1928, first TV broadcast was started. In 1933, first FM broadcast was started. So let's have a look on the important year on which the evolution of wireless technology was occurred. So let's concentrate on the important year on which the remarkable journey of wireless technology was started. First, we have already known that in ancient times people used flags, flashing mirrors, smoke signal for communicating purpose. Then in 1831, Faraday demonstrates the electromagnetic induction. Maxwell invented the theory of electromagnetic fields. And Hertz demonstrated with an experiment the wave character of electrical transmission through space. Then comes Marconi. In 1896, he first demonstrated the wireless telegraphy, long wave transmission, high transmission power necessary for long wave transmission. Then 1907, commercial transatlantic connections was happened. In 1915, wireless voice transmission from New York to San Francisco was occurred. In 1920, discovery of short waves by Marconi. In 1926, train phone on the line Hamburg to Berlin. In 1928, many television broadcast trials were introduced. In 1933, frequency modulation was introduced first by Armstrong. In 1958 is the remarkable year in the journey of wireless communication. At that year, ANETS in Germany was started. ANETS is the first mobile network. It is purely analog in nature and connection set up only from the mobile station. No handover was happened and operator must be needed for mobile connection. At that time, mobile network was very, very bulky and huge. We need a car to carry the mobile network. We need an operator every time. So obviously, it can understood that though it is the inception of mobile network, its inception of wireless technology. In 1972, BNets came in Germany. Basically, some specifications are added in ANets and we are introduced to BNets. It is also in analog in nature, connection set up from the fixed network to, but location of the mobile station has to be known, otherwise connection, call connection cannot be set up. In 1979, NMT, Nordic Mobile Telephony, was introduced at 450 megahertz. It is introduced in Scandinavian countries and it is most popular in Saudi Arabia. In 1982, start of GSM specification. NMT was first, belongs to first generation, but GSM belongs to second generation, and the specification of GSM started in 1982. In 1983, start of American AMPS, Advanced Mobile Phone System, which is also analog in nature. It's a first generation mobile telephony. Analog FM transmission is used, but the main issue is security issue. The first generation mobile network is not totally secure. Encryption is not done and the network is not secure. Anyone can tap your phone. For first generation mobile telephony, the spectrum utilization is also poor and the billing cost, call cost, is very, very high. Then in 1984, CT1, cordless telephony standard one, was started in Europe. So CT1 standard means cordless telephony. Cordless telephony CT1 is used for only voice transmission. In 1986, CNets in Germany was introduced. Analog voice transmission, handover is possible, digital signaling, automatic location of mobile device. We can see that from ANets to BNets, CNets is much superior than those of that. In 1991, specification of DECT comes. DECT means Digital European Cordless Telephone. And some of them was operated in 1880 to 1900 megahertz, and the range is 100 to 500 meter range. Authentication, voice encryption up to several 10,000 user per kilometer square, used in more than 50 countries. DECT was very, very popular not only in Europe but also in other countries. Digital European Cordless Telephony. In 1992, start of GSM. GSM is the start of 2G technology, second generation mobile telephony. In second generation mobile telephony, we are entered into the digital era. In first generation mobile telephony, we see that analog FM transmission is used, but from GSM technology, we are introduced to digital technique, time division, multiple access, and CDMA technique. And handover is possible, routing is possible, international roaming is also possible. You can send data, text message also, voice messages also. So we now enter in second generation mobile telephony. In 1994, ENETS comes in Germany. In 1996, HyperLAN, high performance radio local area network. In 1997, wireless LAN came into the picture. Wireless LAN standard is also known as IEEE 802.11. In 1998, some specification, or we can say some standard, are added in GSM. And GSM, that is second generation mobile telephony, was improved to third generation, towards third generation. We can say that there is a generation between 2G and 3G, that is called 2.5 generation, and UMTS, edge technology, GPRS technology is known as 2.5 generation. In 1999, Bluetooth for Piconets come, IEEE standard 802.11B comes. start of WAP WAP wireless application protocol. In 2000, GSM with higher data rates come HSCSD, that is high speed circuit switch data network, offers very high speed over the GSM network. First GPRS was introduced in GSM network and the data rate was increased 50 kilobits per second. Then comes to the UMTS. In 2001, start of third generation mobile telephony. CDMA 2000 in Korea, UMTS test in Europe, FOMA in Japan. So let's have a look on the different generation of mobile technology. We can see for first generation mobile telephony, the service type is only analog voice. For 2G, digital voice. For 2.5G, capacity is much more increased and data is sent in terms of packet. That means packet switch data. 3G comes with higher capacity. Data speed is much more than higher than 2.5G. And obviously the 4G is also much more higher than 3G. So every time we are passing through each and every generation, we are experiencing more and more high data speed. We can see the representative standards for first generation is AMPS and TACS. TACS means Total Access Communication System. Second generation GSM. 2.5 generation is GPRS, HSCSD, edge technology. For third generation, the standard is UMTS, IMT 2000, WCDMA. Multiple address techniques were used. For first generation, we used only FDMA. For second generation, we used TDMA and CDMA, combination of that. For third generation, we only used the higher version of CDMA. And for fourth generation, we use WaveDMA, that is orthogonal frequency division multiplexing. This is the brief idea about the different generation of mobile technology. In our next lecture, we will go through first generation, second generation one by one in details. Now, before going on to that chapter also, let's have an introduction to different types of wireless network. WLAN, Wireless Local Area Network. It provides wireless connectivity within a limited exposure area, such as a hospital, airport, university, gas plant, or healthcare providers. WWAN, that is Wireless Wide Area Network. The name suggests that the network is very wide. It is not a local. Extends over a large distance or place. Connect different smaller networks such as local area network and metropolitan area network. WMAN, Wireless Metropolitan Area Network. Fast communication of network within the metropolitan area can span up to 50 km. WPAN, Wireless Personal Area Network, used to interconnect the devices based on Bluetooth technology in a central location like a desk. The range of personal area network is about 30 feet. So that's all for this lecture. In this lecture, we have learned about the evolution of wireless technology, that is the history of wireless technology. And Marconi, we can say that he is the father of the radio wave propagation. First wireless technology invented through his hand. And then we are introduced to different generation of mobile telephony, first generation to fourth generation. And each and every generation, we are experiencing more and more data speed. We are introduced to different wireless network also. In my next lecture, we are going to introduce the first generation mobile telephony in details. So thank you. Thanks for patience hearing and hope to see you again in my next session. Thank you.